I feel uncomfortable with the way of answering, say, the problem of evil by saying, well, free will is necessary because if there was no free will, there couldn't be any love. We would just be machines, and machines don't love. And so there's this equation between free will and love. Now, notice the way free will is characterized, though. It's tied in with the problem of evil and moral actions. That is, unless we have, and this is one characterization of freedom, the ability to do otherwise. We could be good or we could be bad. If we didn't have the ability to be good or to be bad, the ability to do otherwise, then we wouldn't have the kind of freedom that is necessary for true love to be expressed. Okay, I have a question. Does God display genuine love? Yes. Second question. Does God have the ability to do otherwise where morality comes in? Can God do evil? No. Will we be able to do evil in heaven? I don't think so. Most people don't think so. We will be immutably good at that point. Does this mean that heaven is going to be bereft of love because now we can't choose to do evil? No, obviously it's going to be thick with love. And God is fully love. He defines love. He's the ground of love, yet he is not capable of evil. This is why I think it's a mistake to kind of tie the free will, ability to do evil question in with the ability to love. Because if that works, then God can't be loving because he can't be evil. He can't choose evil. And there's not going to be any love in heaven. Obviously, this doesn't work.